Hello wonderful person, this is Anton, and in today's video we're going to be imagining what would happen if you fell through a gas giant. Specifically, let's actually fall through Saturn, just like the Cassini mission back in 2017. So let's just imagine that here you are working for NASA, orbiting Saturn, and suddenly something happens, and unfortunately your cable snaps, and you start losing orbital velocity, and then start falling into this beautiful gas giant. At which point you might actually start freaking out. Now let's actually find out what would happen as you go through these layers of gas giant stuff and what would actually end up happening at the end. And of course, back home on Earth, the NASA and whoever else is involved with the mission is probably freaking out, but they're curious to find out what actually happens to your body. Now, as you start falling through the upper atmosphere of Saturn, you'll actually realize that the gravity here is not that much stronger than on Earth, so your actual velocity will be very similar to the upper atmospheres of Earth, and you're going to be falling through some layers that might seem familiar but have different color. And these first layers are just going to be ammonia clouds, specifically white ammonia clouds, but your descent speed is going to be relatively large. You might be moving at speeds close to 1 km/s, yet views will be pretty spectacular. The temperature, however, is going to be pretty cold, so you may want to bring extra layers inside your suit, but it is going to be slowly warming up. About 15 minutes later, things will start changing, and you'll actually start experiencing slight darkness, and as you go deeper and deeper into the atmosphere, it's going to become darker and darker. Now, a few minutes later, you're going to start seeing a second deck of clouds, and this is actually slightly different in composition. These are ammonium hydrosulfide and ammonium sulfide clouds, so they're actually going to be brown in color. And the air pressure at this point actually increases to above the air pressure even on the surface of Earth, so you're going to start slowing down quite dramatically because the gravity here is actually about the same as on Earth, but the atmospheric pressure increases with your fall. And right after you pass the second layer of clouds, things will get slightly, or actually dramatically darker. You're going to actually barely see even your own hands now. And then a few minutes later, you're going to start reaching the third layer of clouds, and the pressure here is going to start dramatically increasing to 4, 5, 6, and almost 10 atmospheres. So you're going to actually feel quite squeezed if you didn't bring some sort of a pressurization device inside your suit. And as you're falling through these water clouds that look kind of similar to Earth, you actually start seeing a lot of interesting things, including lightning that is going to brighten your day a little bit, or possibly electrocute you and kill you right there. And with pressure being at least 5 atmospheres now, you actually might start experiencing what's known as the oxygen toxicity. This is actually a condition that starts occurring and can even kill you if you bring a normal air composition inside your suit. So you actually have to start changing the composition of your air that you breathe in order for you not to die from toxicity of oxygen. And now things get pretty dark and you start getting really compressed. But the thing is, since you're mostly water, only the air inside of you will get compressed. The rest of you will actually be fine. Now you start seeing a lot of lightning and thunder, and you probably start getting really, really scared because you're going to die pretty soon. And as you fall through, you actually start experiencing quite a lot of winds with speeds almost 200 m/s or 720 km/h, and things become really, really dark. Now, this is actually the part where the temperature might actually become comfortable, 23 degrees Celsius, basically room temperature. But as the time passes, after about half an hour, you're actually going to start getting in trouble as the temperature increases to almost 100 degrees Celsius, or the boiling temperature of water. More pressure, more darkness, very, very hot. And as things warm up, you realize that hydrogen no longer behaves as a gas and it becomes very liquidy. So you basically float through this hydrogen that becomes more and more hot. First, 1000 degrees Celsius, when it actually starts glowing red and you finally start seeing things, and obviously die, but let's assume that your suit has some sort of protection. Then 5000 degrees Celsius, and basically it starts glowing kind of like a sun or a star. And then you reach 10,000 degrees Celsius, and this is at a depth of about 20,000 kilometers, where things become very unusual, very strange, and you start experiencing things like helium rain, for example, which is something that you don't see very often on Earth, or actually at all. And at this depth, obviously you're probably dead a long time, but we're assuming that you're still alive for some reason, you reach what's known as liquid metal hydrogen. Now this is essentially hydrogen behaving as a liquid metal, which is what's responsible for generating a tremendously powerful magnetosphere around all of the gas giants. And at this point, hydrogen starts acting as a kind of a supercritical material that is kind of liquid, kind of gas, and is same density as you. So you don't sink anymore. But let's just say you brought some lead shoes or some other material that allows you to sink even more. And so you actually go through the unusual liquid metal hydrogen and start sinking even more. Now, this material will actually dissolve everything, including you and your suit. But we're imagining things, so we're going to imagine that you didn't get to dissolve in this unusual material and you keep sinking even lower. The temperatures here are ridiculous, as are pressures. The pressure is probably about 2 million atmospheres and the temperature is over 10,000 degrees Celsius and possibly even 11,000 degrees Celsius. But nothing stops us at this point. We keep sinking more and more for about 15,000 kilometers. And because this material is actually very, very dense, you're going to be following through this for many, many weeks. And at some point, you're going to reach solid ground. Now, this is actually made out of rock, exotic ices, metals, and a combination of materials we probably can't even imagine because we've never seen them, except for some extreme cases in the lab. You're basically standing on what might be considered to be the core of a gas giant, and you kind of start slowly walking away, hoping one day to return to Earth, but in reality, you're long dead, because, well, there's no way you can survive in these conditions. Anyway, so that's all I wanted to show you in this video, and hopefully you learned a little bit about what would happen if you fell through a gas giant, specifically Saturn. Now, it's not something you want to experience, because it's probably going to be very painful, but you know, we'll talk more about this in some of the future videos, and thank you for watching, come back tomorrow to learn something else, I'll see you guys later, space out, and as always, bye-bye.